You don't need to be a professional to manage your Facebook ads for your online store. You just need to sit down, buckle up, and follow through the 6 steps I'm going to share in this video. This is your one-stop shop for Facebook advertising. Hey, it's Wes from Printful. In this video, we'll go over all you need to know about Facebook and Instagram ads in one sitting. How to find an audience, set up retargeting, create ads, and keep it all up and running. If you want to jump to a specific part of this video, you can do so by using the timestamps in the description below. Before we begin, make sure to subscribe to our channel and tap on the little bell icon to get notified about our latest videos and never miss out on new ways to make your store more successful. Now, this shouldn't come as a surprise to you. You'll need to create a Facebook page to create ads on both Facebook and Instagram. If you haven't done that yet, head to Facebook and create a page now. There's a link in the description that will guide you through it. An Instagram account isn't necessary to launch Instagram ads, but if you're interested in Instagram marketing, watch our video that'll teach you all about it. There's a link in the description below. Once you've set up your Facebook page, move to business.facebook.com. We're going to organize all of our work from there. If you haven't used Facebook Business Manager before, you'll be asked to create an account for your business. We recommend using the Business Manager because that's the only way to set up most of the features that Facebook ads offer, including the ones we're going to go through in this video. Once you've signed up, you'll be asked to add your Facebook page to the Business Manager account and create an ad account. If you already have an ad account for your page, you can claim it. There's a link to a step-by-step guide of this whole process in the description below. Note that you should always choose a trusted partner to add as a second admin for your business manager, even if you plan to work alone, just in case you get locked out of your account. Now the fun part. The audience for your Facebook and Instagram ads should be people you're selling to, those you had in mind when designing for your store and your products. If you're not sure about the details yet, don't worry, because that's what we're going to start with. One way to start your audience research is the Audience Insights tool. Facebook has an abundance of valuable information on its users and your potential customers, and here's where you can play around with it. There are two ways to use the tool. First, if your Facebook page already has a following, you can add it here and see specific details about your existing audience. If you're an international seller, don't forget to delete the United States variable in the location tab here. If you're just starting and there's not much to go off of yet, don't worry. The second way to use the tool is to create an audience from scratch. For example, I'm going to see what I can gather about the audience I have in mind, new dads that are into computer programming. In the Audience Insights tool, you can select any number of variables starting from location, age, and gender, to interest, education, relationship status, and even political affiliations in the US. Which variables you mix together depends on what your target audience is, and we recommend playing around and experimenting with this tool, even when your audience is well established. You can experiment with other audience segments later on, especially when promoting products that need more specific targeting. For example, while your audience might be new dads, you could create a product that is meant specifically for newlywed dads. Once you've started to flesh out your audience, you're going to notice that in some categories, there's a very low percentage of potential customers. I'd recommend removing those age groups altogether so that you don't waste your time spending money on an age group which is less likely to be your target audience. Next, if you switch over to Page Likes tab, you can see pages and categories your target audience is interested in. This section will help you in two ways: narrowing down your audience and keeping track of your competitors. Here you can see that while there is some dad stuff here, there's not enough to say that you've narrowed it down to a niche. Let's add an additional interest, parenting. Now you can see a lot more dad-oriented Facebook pages here. You can click around and check those pages out, learn what kinds of posts work for them, what ads they have, and you can also be more certain that this is the audience you should be aiming for. The next tab in the Audience Insights tool is locations. If you have a very local product, you might want to use the Top Towns and Cities tab. But for this audience, I'm going to switch to Top Countries. This chart right here shows that you could have an audience for your niche products not only in the US, but also the UK, Canada, and Australia. Knowing this will help you narrow down your audience even more, and you won't spend too much money on countries where ads are cheaper, but your audience isn't present. Next, the Activity tab. Here you can see if your audience often engages with Facebook content in general. Keep this in mind and be wary of audiences where engagement rates are low. These people are less likely to like your page or buy your products. You should also pay attention to what devices your audience is using. As you can see, most people in this niche audience are mobile-only users, so you have to adapt both your ads and your website for mobile shoppers. Now, when you go back to the Demographics tab, take a look at the Relationship Status graph. Most people in our audience are married, which means we could also target their partners as potential customers. This is especially useful when you market your products as a gift on Father's Day, for example. Once you're done tweaking your audience, save it by clicking here. Then open all tools and go to audiences. Here you'll find all the audiences you created and get familiar with the real secret to Facebook advertising, retargeting. Note that there are three types of audiences on Facebook: saved, custom, and lookalike. A saved audience is like the one we just created, based on specific variables, like demographics, interests, behaviors, and other Facebook user data. These kinds of audiences will work for you if you're just starting and have to build a customer base from scratch. A custom audience, however, is a more specific group of people who already have engaged with your content. Custom audiences are the ones you're using for retargeting. For most online stores, 95% of visitors leave without buying. These people have stumbled upon your store but left without a purchase. Maybe they got distracted, maybe the timing was bad, or maybe they just aren't sure about your product yet. Retargeting means reminding your potential customers that they have unfinished business with your shop. The average return of investment of retargeting ads is 200%. That is, for every $10 you spend on your ads, you will get at least $20 back. It works so well because it's easier to convert people who already know and recognize your brand than those who've never heard of you. The data sources for custom audiences on Facebook are divided into two groups. First, there's the data Facebook and Instagram has collected for you. Like what percentage of a video post they've seen, have they interacted with your page in any way, have they attended any of your events, and so on. Almost no setup is needed for this as the data is collected automatically. The only thing you'll need to connect is Instagram if you plan on using that platform for marketing. The other group is your sources. That means website traffic, existing list of customers, and other data. This is the heart and soul of retargeting campaigns. Using this data, you can find people who have looked at your store but not bought anything, people who are interested in a specific product that you can advertise to again, and tons of other options. For this, you'll need to install Facebook Pixel. Facebook Pixel is a smart little code that you can put into your site that connects your customers with their Facebook profiles, making it possible for you to advertise to them on Facebook. To create a new Facebook Pixel, simply click on the website traffic source. A new window with a detailed guide on creating the pixel and installing it on your site will appear, so don't worry about getting lost. For most e-commerce platforms, the setup is as easy as pushing a few buttons. You can also find a guide of how to install Facebook Pixels in the description below. Once you've set up Facebook Pixel, you'll be able to target people who have visited your checkout page but didn't visit your thank you page. That way, you're targeting people who have abandoned their cart and urge them to finish what they started. For that, you can use the include and exclude buttons over here. Now that that's done, let's move on to the third audience type, the lookalike audience. Lookalike audiences are only available for setup on top of already existing custom audiences. The idea is simple. Facebook takes the data from the custom audience you created and, if it's large enough, shows your ads to similar people who might behave the same way. When creating a lookalike audience, first you need to choose the custom audience to base this off of. Then you can choose the location of the new target group. For example, if you know that your current audience is from the UK based on your audience insights, but you want to find a similar audience in the US, type that in here. And finally, you need to choose how much do you want your lookalike audience to differ from the custom audience on a scale from 1 to 10%. 1 is the most similar to your base, and 10% means a bigger, broader audience. The percentage you should put here depends on your custom audience size. For a bigger audience, you should use a smaller percentage, as Facebook will have enough data to work off and create a decent-sized lookalike audience. If you're just beginning and have a small custom audience sample, we recommend you use a broader audience for best results. If the Facebook algorithm has enough data, it can be incredibly effective in finding the right people for your store, and you'll eventually be able to leave the targeting to the algorithm. Generally speaking, it is better to focus on individuals who have already shown interest in your brand. So even if you need to start with saved audiences because you haven't had enough traffic to your site or social media profiles, be sure to build those custom audiences along the way. Let's go through the process of creating an ad campaign. For that, you're going to need to use the Ads Manager tool. This will be the central station for all of your campaigns and ads. To begin, click on Create Ad. First, you'll need to choose your marketing objective. Depending on what you choose, the Facebook algorithm will find people within your saved, custom, or lookalike audiences who are most likely to do the thing that you have chosen as your objective. Facebook offers a lot of options here, but the ones that we're going to focus on are engagement, traffic, and conversions, exactly in that order. First, engagement. When you've just started your online store, there isn't much use of trying to get traffic to your site if the Facebook page that you're launching your ads from have zero followers or the posts you've posted have no likes, shares, or comments. That's where the engagement objective comes in. Engagement-oriented ads won't necessarily bring you a lot of revenue, but they are perfect for giving your brand more credibility. You can use engagement ads on existing posts on your page, and don't be afraid to post content not directly connected to your products. Try out memes or engagement-oriented giveaways, anything that might push for more interaction. This is a great way to grow your following. Once a person has engaged with your post from your page, you can invite them to like the page directly with the invite button under the post. Next, traffic. Once you've got enough people following you and are ready to engage with your Facebook content, you can direct them to your store. This is a good way to find out where they go once they're in your store, get them familiar with your products, and read more about you. Traffic-oriented ads may get you your first sales, but don't count on it. These kinds of ads are much better for gathering data on people that you will be able to use for retargeting later. To really get them to buy, you'll need to focus on conversions. The conversions objective will push the Facebook algorithm to find people more likely to actually do something on your store. The aim might be purchases, signups, or subscriptions, whatever suits you best. For the conversions to work, you'll need to set up pixel events that you want your customers to do. For example, one event can be making a purchase, another adding a product to the cart, another subscribing to the newsletter. You can create a new event by going to your pixels page in your business manager. There will be a guide on how to set up specific events there, but we'll leave a link to it in the description as well. Remember to test your events to verify that they are working correctly. You can do that in the Pixel Control Panel. Once you've chosen your objective, you can give your campaign a name that you'll recognize and decide whether or not you want to A/B test it. A/B testing is useful when starting up and trying out different audiences, but more on that later. Next, your audiences. You can create a new audience from scratch and even save it to your library for later use here, or you can use one of the ones you've set up in the previous steps here. The audience creation process here is similar to the one in Audience Insights in the step 2 of this video. As for ad placements, in most cases, I'd recommend trusting the algorithm to find the best placement for your ads with automatic placements. However, if you have a Facebook or Instagram specific ad, that's when you should edit your placements and select just those that fit your content. The next thing you should definitely pay attention to is daily or lifetime budget. If you have a lot of money on your hands, you can choose a daily spending limit and leave it at that. But I'd recommend setting a lifetime budget and schedule the time period in which you want to spend it. This avoids accidents like forgetting about a campaign and letting it run on $50 a day for a month, because that is a lot of money. And finally, once you've set your budget, it's time to create the actual ad content. When it comes to your ad content, there are a few things to keep in mind. All parts of your ad can be ranked in order of importance. Facebook already has created a sort of visual hierarchy for their post. The bigger the element, the more importance it has. Remember this hierarchy when you're creating your ads. Don't put the most valuable information in the description link, for example, as your audience is very unlikely to read it all. So let's start with the biggest element, the photo. There are a few things that are proven to work for product ad visuals on Facebook. First, a high-quality, zoomed-in product photo. You want your product to be clearly visible on all screens, so a close-up is a must. Second, colorful images. Bright colors will help you stand out more and catch the attention of your customers. And the third, people pointing. It is proven that pictures of people pointing and making eye contact increases positive feelings towards the product, and it encourages consumers to buy it. In addition to these, you must also remember the 20% text rule. All ads on Facebook must have less than 20% of text in their image. That includes photos as well as videos and linked thumbnails. If you don't follow this rule, your ad might not get approved, much less hope for decent results and revenue. A useful tool for checking whether or not Facebook will accept your ad is the text overlay tool. There's a link in the description. Here, you can upload your images before putting them in your ads, and the tool will rate the amount of text in your image. It is recommended to always stay with the green OK rating for good results. This tool is also useful for checking images that will go on your feed without paid promotions. The 20% rule is based on the fact that the photos with less text get more engagements and look better on the feed. As for the ad copy, I'd suggest three things to keep in mind. First, use social proof when possible. Nothing works better than showing that there are people who've already bought your product, trust you, and recommend you to others. Second, good grammar is a must. Plus, you should also try to use words that your audience will relate to and recognize. For example, instead of male products, you should use words like men, boys, or gentlemen. Another proven thing to work in product ads is a deal, giveaway, or an exclusive offer, like free shipping or coupons. Play with your audience's emotions a little. Create urgency, raise curiosity, and use a sense of humor if you can. When you're just starting out, definitely use existing posts for your ads. That way, you will have both new ad material to promote and fresh content for your Facebook page. And last but not least, don't be afraid to keep an eye on your competitors. Use the Audience Insights tool to find out what other Facebook pages your audience follows and learn from their success. You can see all of the ads that a page is currently running in the Facebook page transparency section. Creating your first ad is just the beginning. Now you need to test if it works. As I mentioned before, the Facebook algorithm can be incredibly effective in finding the right people for your store, but you have to give it something to work with. For each campaign, you can create an unlimited number of different ads. For example, you could switch up the audience, use the same ad for the custom and lookalike audiences. Another option is to create different variations of the same ad for the same audience. For example, use an image in one ad and a carousel in another. Now put $5 to $15 on each of those ad sets and set them to run for a day or two. After that, see which one works best and increase their budget. Terminate the ads that don't yield results, but don't judge too fast. Run the ads for at least 24 hours to get a reliable result. The algorithm needs some time to find the audience that works best for you. Once your sales start rolling in, you can repeat the cycle with new campaigns and ad variations, and direct your revenue to test more ads. Don't be afraid to keep running successful ads. Let the algorithm find new people to show your successful ad to. You don't always have to think of something new. You can customize your Ad Manager dashboard to show you those metrics that are useful for deciding which ads work best. Find the Customize Columns option on your dashboard. How you organize it depends on your goals, but I'd recommend putting up frequency. This metric shows you how many times one person has seen your ad. If this number goes higher than 3 or 4, it means that the ad isn't reaching any new people, and you should probably shut it down. Other metrics to keep an eye on are quality and engagement rate rankings, as well as cost per result. You can compare these metrics against each of your ads to determine which ones are doing better. And finally, while the Facebook algorithm is working to find your new customers, you should pay attention to where you're leading them to. Make sure your landing pages are finished and look good. Remember to test them from mobile devices and different browsers. Concentrate on gaining more likes and followers and encourage your customers to post reviews to get social proof for your products. Remember to stay consistent throughout all of your channels. Have the same writing and visual style on your site and your Facebook page. For more tips on how to take care of your brand image, check out our video on the top 10 e-commerce store mistakes you're making. And that's it. You can find a checklist of all 6 steps in the description below, along with all the resources that I mentioned in this video. What else do you want to know about marketing your store? Let me know in the comments below. Hey, Wes from Printful here. Hope you enjoyed that video. Go check out the other videos on our channel and don't forget to hit subscribe to never miss the latest content. To get started with Printful today, just click on the link in the description below.